In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of foot muscles and function. I want to classify what muscle groups do what kind of movement. You know, anatomy and function of foot muscles and ankle muscles are very complicated, and it sounds very difficult at first time. So I want to be as simple as possible. I would like to divide ankle joint 4 quadrants, okay? I want to separate ankle joint front and back. This is axis of dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Muscles which pass above this axis that do dorsiflexion. Dorsiflexion, and the muscles which pass beneath this line is going to be plantar flexion. Okay, main two movements in ankle joint, right? Dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. There should be two more movements in ankle joint. That's inversion and eversion. Actually, axis of these two movements is a little bit complicated. So it's a little bit diagonal, like this. This is inversion. Okay, muscles which pass medial to the axis is inversion. The other side is eversion. By the way, this is right foot. Right foot. You are looking right foot from superior view. Okay, so this quadrant is dorsiflexion, let's say D, dorsiflexion plus eversion, right? This quadrant is plantar flexion plus eversion, right? This quadrant is what? Plantar flexion and inversion. This quadrant is dorsiflexion and inversion. Important thing is you remember the direction of axis of each movement. Plantar flexion, dorsiflexion is easy. That's transverse axis. Inversion, eversion axis is a little bit diagonal. This way. Okay? Now let me explain muscles which pass each quadrant. Okay? Again, this is axis for plantar flexion and dorsiflexion. This is axis for inversion and eversion, right? Let me explain this quadrant. This is for plantar flexion and inversion. There are many muscles passing at this quadrant. Let's say there are muscles like this and this and this. There are three muscles passing at this quadrant on medial part. They are tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, and flexor digitorum longus. These muscles pass this quadrant. Thus, these guys do plantar flexion and inversion, right? Don't forget, there's huge muscle groups on posterior part of calcaneus. These guys are like gastrocnemius and soleus. These two guys are strong plantar flexor, right? So these two guys don't do a lot of inversion. They are very, very weak inversion, right? It's like nothing. It's extremely weak inversion. It's like most of anatomy books don't say these guys are doing inversion. So you can ignore inversion for gastrocnemius and soleus, but theoretically, gastrocnemius and soleus pass in this quadrant. So you may say, okay, gastrocnemius and soleus can do inversion. Okay, but main movement is plantar flexion, right? Anyway, that's for this quadrant. This is for plantar flexion and inversion. Let's go to this quadrant. This is for inversion and dorsiflexion. This quadrant is very simple. There is one muscle. This muscle is tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior. This is strong dorsiflexion muscle, right? So again, this is inversion and dorsiflexion. That's it. This quadrant is only for tibialis anterior. Let's go to this quadrant. This is for eversion and dorsiflexion. There are two muscles in this quadrant. First one is that passes about this area. This is extensor hallucis longus. Extensor hallucis longus. This muscle can do dorsiflexion, obviously, but this muscle also can do eversion. Really? Yes, but it's very slight movement for eversion. Somehow, some anatomy books or some anatomy information says extensor hallucis longus may do inversion as well. I guess because the axis of inversion, eversion may be different, a little bit, depends on people. Some people's axis can run like this way, or some other people's axis are a little bit more horizontal. So I guess that is why extensor hallucis longus can do both for eversion and inversion. However, tibialis anterior is obviously for inversion. This is important thing. Extensor hallucis longus may do both eversion and inversion. If you look textbook, extensor hallucis longus runs at this quadrant. Okay. Next one, next muscle runs about this area. This is extensor digitorum longus. Extensor digitorum longus. Okay, this is for dorsiflexion and eversion. Let's go to last quadrant. That is here. This is for eversion and plantar flexion. There are two muscles. These guys run around this area. This is fibularis longus and fibularis brevis. Fibularis longus and fibularis brevis. These guys run around this area. Yep, this is obviously for plantar flexion and eversion. If you divide to these quadrants, it's easy to memorize which muscles do what kind of function. Okay, again, this area is for plantar flexion and inversion. This is dorsiflexion and inversion. This is dorsiflexion and eversion. This is plantar flexion and eversion. I guess this video helps your understanding of movement of ankle joint. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.